This video has two main topics. The first part will show you how I learned rigging with Blender and what was necessary to do. I will show you my path and experience, and this should be a guide for rigging beginners. The second part is for all people who completed part 1 successfully, and I continue with a practical example. I will create a humanoid character rig with Rigify and add an object or weapon slot to it, so that I can manipulate it freely. This weapon slot will be not adjustable in game engines and is only for animation purposes in Blender itself. But the animation can be exported in the end, just that you know. I have learned rigging in Autodesk Maya 10 years ago. Basically, I got a good understanding what is rigging for and how rigging should work. For sure, Maya is a different software than Blender, but the creation process is pretty much the same. I absolutely forgot everything about how to create and rig, but some technical conceptions remains. I remembered that rigging was really confusing for me, and I didn't liked it in the past. However, my goal was to learn rigging in Blender so that I will be able to create a humanoid character rig with an object or weapon slot. I was wondering if I will find everything on YouTube or somewhere else. The answer is yes, and there was even more. Each Blender version contains a free rigging add-on called Rigify. Just go to the preferences, enter the add-on section, and search for Rigify. Enable this, and that's all so far. Basically, without this add-on, you will only find single bone in the armature section when you want to add the first part of your rig. With this add-on enabled, there is more, for example the human meta rig. So this is easy going. But hold on, give me some more time to explain. I was searching on YouTube and the internet how to use Rigify properly. Maybe there's something I missed and I need to consider. The first videos only show me what I already know. Add amateur human meta rig. And this meta rig looks pretty good, and I was impressed that it is that easy. The only thing which bothered me is how to add now the object or weapon slot. So I continued searching for Rigify tutorials. Then I found CG Dive, which was my solution. As I mentioned in my How to Learn Rigging, Animation and FBX Export Optimization introduction video, I will not produce any rigging tutorials like CG Dive because you will find everything you need to know on this channel. Just enter the playlist section and there you find a list of all necessary tutorials which covers the basics of Rigify. Rig anything with Rigify is the one which you should start with. The playlist contains 15 videos which you should watch and learn from them. Toto is a very good teacher and try to explain Rigify for beginners. Take the time to watch every part carefully. This is really important. Don't skip any part. Nevertheless, this playlist contains the basics of Rigify and how to work with it. You will get a decent knowledge, but there is definitely more about to learn with rigging and Rigify. If you want to learn more and get really good detailed information, then I would advise you to try his advanced Rigify chapters. Those videos are only available on Gumroad and I will place the link to this course in the description below. The videos are not for free, but you need to understand that you already got a full basic tutorial series for free. And usually, if you want to learn something, then it is as well not a problem to buy a book or something like this, isn't it? A price for those videos will not hurt anybody and it will support Toto and his work to continue creating tutorials for us. The price is the way how we say thank you to Toto. He put a lot of effort to these videos. He deserves this. Principally, you can as well learn how to rig without Rigify, but you shouldn't do that. This is just what I found out so far and there's no negative aspect with Rigify. So why making your life more complicated? The next part of this video will require all 15 videos from CG Dive how to rig anything with Rigify, because this will be the basic knowledge you need to know to continue. Let's head to the practical part of the video. I want to create a humanoid rig with an object or weapon slot, because I want to animate the axe freely. It should be possible that the axe follows the hand movement and it should be possible to move around freely as well. The axe should be able to stick to the hand and to the belt. Both should be possible. Remember that this rig will be not adjustable in game engines. I only create the slots for animation purposes And for sure we are able to export the animation in the end, but you will not have any control in game engines afterwards. If you are searching an answer for this, then I advise you to check out this video from PRIGG Pickout, Rigging Equipment and Weapon Slot in Blender. But this video was too confusing for me. It was very hard to follow him. I didn't find any tutorials for weapon slots in Rigify. So this is just my simple solution. Rigging is too complex for me to find a better solution. Just for information, you will be able to download this character for free to follow this tutorial. You find the link in the description below, but you are able to use any other 3D character too. Another information before we start is this. Rigify works with so-called rigg types to build up a meta-rig. Todor called them building blocks. All those building blocks together generates the control rig whenever you press generate rig. This control rig is the rig which you use for animating the character. Basically, it is not correct to parent the 3D mesh to this rig, and I will explain why in my next video, meta rig, control rig, game rig. But for demonstration purposes, I will parent the 3D mesh to the control rig in this video a little bit later. Important to know is that pressing the generate button while the meta rig is selected is not a one-shot action. You are able to override the generated rig again and again, test the functionality, and do adjustments for the meta rig and press generate again. Usually this works as well when the 3D mesh is parented to the rig. It will not destroy any skin weights. Let's do some planning for the rig before I start. The object, or here the weapon, will get an own bone which need to interact with the human rig. This means that it need to be part of the human rig in my case. It has to be one rig, not two rigs, because in the end I want to export everything in one single FBX. So it is necessary to implement the weapon to the character rig. But this doesn't mean that the axe and the human body mesh need to be one object. The amount of objects in the Outliner which will be parented to the rig is not important. What I learned during the creation process of my last project was to think about the steps you need to do later. Skin weights will be important later too, and I want to parent the character to the rig with automatic weights. In my opinion, it is better to create a humanoid rig first and parent the character to the rig. Then add the weapon slot to the meta rig and regenerate the control rig. So you will get new controls without disturbing the current skin weights. But I will show you this now step by step in the following part. Well guys, we are now live here in the 3D viewport and this is my 3D character and we are able to just enable or disable the texture, but currently maybe it's better to do this without any texture, so we see what they are doing. And this is our humanoid character, and for sure the proportions are a little bit different than an ordinary human, but you see this, it's basically a human. We have here two objects. On the first is here the bottle thing here, and the second one is the axe. We are basically able to count both as objects which can be animated, but I will keep this here and just want to have this little axe here. And I just select all the faces which are important for the axe and this here as well. And currently the character is this and without the eyes and without the mouth. So in edit mode I just separate this because I want to count this as a single object, and the axe should be an own object and the deformation should be a little bit different. So okay, so first I go here to origin and say origin to 3D cursor or origin to geometry. Okay, so I'm bring this in position because it's a little bit off. I will hide this for so far. So let's test this out. How is this? What is the best way to make this straight again? And as well, it should be looking for position, in my opinion. It should be somewhere something like this. Is this good? This is looking good. Okay, so basically, I think this looks fine. So let's think about geometry. Not 100%, but basically good. Okay, so basically good. Origin to 3D cursor. So this is my object, which should be animated, and I want to use this axe freely without any without any control of the hand controls or something like this when I'm creating the rig now. So this was the first preparation step. So we have this as a single object, we have our character as a single object. This is fine. So modeling is done so far. And we are able to start now with the rig immediately. So very important is to check, is my Rigify add-on enabled. So we are here in the add-on tab in the preference window, and I just search for Rigify, and yes, it is enabled, it's checked, perfect. So when we are starting now with the first bone, then we are able to immediately start with Rigify. So just start with the first bone. I just go Shift A to add something, and I will go to amateur, and we don't use any of this because if you watch the tutorials from Tutor, then you know that we will use a single bone, and this single bone is our amateur, and I will call this just meta rig. Okay, so then I go here to the amateur tab and viewport display. It's as well very important that it should be always in the front, and I want to see the axis. Both are very important. So, but we don't need this. This is just an ordinary amateur bone, so there's nothing special behind this. So I will enter the edit mode, select everything, and just delete the bone. Important is to know that we still have our meta rig here, and we are still in edit mode. So we have a rig selected without any bones, and we are able to just add now our bones, what we need. So our building blocks, like Tutor in his videos. So I can just collapse this. And here we have the Rigify buttons, and the Rigify buttons have all the building blocks which are possible. And when you watch the videos, then just you know that you have to click this arrow, and we are able to search here. And we start with the leg. Just select the leg and add sample. So it's immediately here, and this is for sure a basic human sized leg. And for this cartoony character here, we need to adjust this a little bit. So basically, just bring this into position. I will just slightly move this. And maybe what we need to enable as well is the wireframe, because then we see my mesh geometry, and I have here my edge loops, which are very important for the deformation later. And I know that here is the knee, so in this position it is correct. What is as well important to know is when you just go here to the bone tab, you see that we have the suffix L, and L is always for the left side, and we are able to mirror just later this to the right side, and then it's as well named correctly. But always work with the building blocks as the left on the left side if there's something which need to be mirrored later. So okay, and this will be somewhere here, I guess. Okay, then I go to the side position. This is a little bit annoying because the hand is really big and I don't see anything here, but let's place this somewhere here. Okay, probably just a little bit. This looks good. This here and this here. What we are going to do with this one here, when we just look at this from the bottom side here, then yeah, for sure, basically Toto said that it should be the full white of the shoes, but we have here very tiny width and here a very big width. So what is the best thing what we need to do? So probably I just make this bigger so that we are able to move the foots properly. And as well, when I go to the side view, it should be here on the last position of this foot here. Okay. And hopefully this is in the correct position. Probably I just enter here the wireframe mode, and then we see where our bone is. So basically it looks fine. Okay, and this is all for the food. And I don't need to mirror this immediately, I can do this later as well. So we are still in edit mode, what we will create next, this spine for this character here. So I just shift A and create a new bone, which is basically just an ordinary bone without any rigify type or something like this. It's just an empty bone without anything. And I just do this here. Bring this into position, probably somewhere here. I need to think about where is the middle of the character. And this is, well, very important that you don't place this spine on the actual position of the spine. So it's not on the back here. So we need to, it's better to do this inside of the mesh, so in the center of the volume, okay? Very important is that when we don't use any rigify buttons or building blocks here, then this is just an ordinary bone without any name. And just press F2 for naming this, and I will call this spine, and without any suffix because it's in the center. And go to the side view, and I just place it somewhere here. And probably I will just create 3 more bones with extrude, with the I key to extrude this. So this is the spine, something like this probably. And when you click at this, then you see that we have in suffix 3, 2, 1, and this is the 0 spine part here. So it's fine like this. The only thing what we need to do so that we can generate a working rigify rig, then we need to give this bone a rigify type. And this is a little bit confusing because you need to switch again and again between the armature and the bone tab, and between edit mode and the pose mode. We need to enter the pose mode now. So we have here now, this is in a blue color. And this is now very interesting. Here we have the rigify type. We don't have this in edit mode in the bone section here. So this is a little bit the only thing which is confusing in rigify, in my opinion. So what we need to do is search for spine and give it the proper spine basic, spines basic spine rig type. So now this is in rigify building block as well, like the leg here. Basically, I like to work again or continue working here on this part. Toders continued with the arm, but it's not that hard to continue here. So I will just extrude this part here with I and creating the pelvis. So this is now currently spine 4, but this should be the pelvis. Pelvis dot L. So this bone is now named correctly. And again, and there's no rigify type so far, so just go to the pose mode again and give it the rigify type super copy. Perfect. And this pelvis bone shouldn't get any control. So as Toder, we need to disable control. So the pelvis is finished, but we go now to edit mode again. And I just shift D this bone here and bring it to the upper part here. And probably I will just place it somewhere here because this will be my collar bone. So somewhere like this, I guess. Okay, F2, crawler dot L. And important again, when I go to pose mode, then we have already the super copy here because we copied this bone here, but we need here the control. So the spine and the collar and this and the pelvis are prepared nicely, in my opinion, now. So we can continue with the arm. So front view, I go back to edit mode, and now I want to have a new building block which is forming my arm here. Okay, so what we can do, we go here to the armature tab, and with the rigify buttons we just search for arm. And very important is to select this, because otherwise the leg is still selected and then we will create an leg. We don't need another leg, so just select the arm and add sample. The arm is somewhere in this position here now, and we just are able to grab this and move it somewhere like this. So we have here the upper arm, the lower arm, and the hand itself. And I just place this somewhere in position again. So somewhere here, I guess. And this will be somewhere here. And let's check this out. Where will be this? Somewhere here, I guess. And very important as well, think where is this in... Where is this actually? Okay, so let's check this from the backside. This looks as well good. I just bring this more into position. Hand looks fine too. And the naming convention is already correct. So this is fine. So the next building block will be the fingers, which are, we only have four fingers, not five, because yeah. Toon character, like something like this. So Toto said in his videos that most Rigify rigs works with tentacles as fingers, and this is what we are creating as well next. So I just go again to amateur and search here for tentacle, and just select this again and add sample, and we get this here. And this is the first bone. This is where our rigify type is. Yeah, you see this here. But the bone chain is pointing to this direction. We just take this, rotate this, and bring this, and scale this, and bring this into position. So we have here, somewhere here, the point where the finger starts. Then we have here the next one, and here the next one, and here is the last part. And basically this should work. But when you check this now from the side position, then we need to adjust this a little bit more. Okay. So something like this. Very important is as well that this, yeah, it looks a little bit weird, because the fingers are this fat. Like the character. Very important is that this naming convention is a little bit off, because there's only this bone name here, and we need to rename all of this. So we have bone 2, bone 3, bone 1, bone 2, and bone. But we need to give this a proper name, and this will be the four finger. I will name this forefinger01.l, because it's the left hand. And then we have here forefinger2l, and we have here forefinger3l. Okay, so this is fine. Now we are able to just take this chain here and shift D, place it somewhere here. So I bring it to this position. Okay. And we are doing this again for the pinky finger here. And we should do this again for the thumb. But now we need to adjust as well the position here. Is this in the correct position, or is this somewhere completely off? And I think it's a little bit off. So let's bring this into position. So. Okay, the position is now more or less okay. I think it's fine like this. There are two more things we need to do. The first one is we need to consider the orientation of the axis. So the Z axis is always looking to the side. And this is a little bit rotated. the wrong way, and we need to adjust this as well so that we have later maybe not that problem for animating the fingers and the rotation. And the second thing is we need to rename all of this because we have now wrong names for the bones, and we have here the forefinger, then we have here the middle finger, and here with the pinky finger and the thumb, and we need to rename all of them. And I will do this, and then I will do fix the rotation so that we can later bring this to the right side very easily. So we are almost done here with the rig. We just have nearly everything. What is missing? The head is missing, and I want to have as well a tentacle bone chain here for the beard so that we can animate the beard a little bit so it's not that stare like the head here. So I go to front view. So this is now the next building block. So go here to the amateur tab and search for head. Okay, select it and add sample. And it's somewhere here. It's fine, okay. And I will bring this into position. Where's our spine? So far somewhere here. I will place it here, I guess. And now I will just give the head a proper position. It's very interesting character shape, so maybe it is a little bit weird, but it's okay. So I select now this point here of the last bone of the spine and press Shift S and say cursor to selected. Okay, so now I go to the first part here of the head chain, Shift S and say selection to cursor. Well, when we now bring this at the same and the correct position, so the spine ends here and the neck or the head starts here, then everything is perfect. So let's check this, if everything is correct in the correct position. Looks good. So the only thing what we need to do now is select this first, very first part or bone of the head and enter the pose mode. And there we need to go to the rig type, and we see that the correct rig type is already assigned, but we need to press as well connect chain so that this is really a connected piece and not a loose character. So the head is finished. What we need to do next is I go here to the front view and again go to edit mode. And we will add now the beard, and I will just add here a single tentacle line here. We don't will animate the moustache. It's a very my aesthetical beard, but one tentacle line should completely be okay. So it is, so search here for tentacle, yeah, select it and add sample. Take this. And basically it should be on the zero position. Rotate epsilon 180, so this is now correct. Place it somewhere here, bring it into correct size. Okay, whereas somewhere here will be the chin, I guess, somewhere here. Then this will be the line. Looks good. And the only thing what we need to do here is as well, we see wrong bone names, so I will give this the bone beard 1, beard 2, and beard 3. So everything is done. So This is all what we need to do for the building blocks so far for the humanoid character. Later we will add something to create the weapon slots or the object slots, but this is more or less the basic human character. It's a toon character, it's fine. What we need to do now is, for sure, this is just the left side, we need to bring everything to the right side as well. So, what we need to do, just select everything which is left. So basically, we just have here the cola, the pelvis is not selected. We have the arms, we have all the fingers, we have the legs. Okay, this looks good. And then when we selected everything, yes, the head is as well correct. Then I just go here to amateur and say Symmetrize. And when you just check this out, then we see we have the correct suffix. So we have here left, here right. And as well with the fingers, with the arms. And I just check this out now if there is everything correct as well with the rigify types. So we have here arm, this is fine. We have here as well the basic super copy, here two, and here's the legs. So the character is so far finished with the Symmetrize function, and now we need to parent the single bone so that everything is one whole character rig and not a loose falling apart structure. Yeah, you know, this is as well very easy. We just need to parent the single bones with each other. So for example, I just select now in edit mode the leg part here. And what is really helping you is when you go to the end panel and there you find X axis Nero and just enable this, because if you don't do this, then you have to do this the whole stuff as well on the right side. And this is, you can spare some time with this. So just select this part here and this, Control P and keep offset. And now you see a tiny black dotted line here, which is telling you that this is now parented. And as well on the other side. So when we go now here to pose mode, and I just move this, then the leg is moving with you. And this is very important. So this is very important for building up this rig. So again, I just select this bone here and then this and Control P, keep offset. And if I check this now, then everything is moving with me. This is as well good to know. Okay, the same thing is here with the fingers. I will just select this and this finger here, and at least this, the hand bone, Control P, keep offset. So now the fingers are following my hand. Then my arm with the cola, Control P, keep offset. And basically you should see here on the other side as well line, so everything is working with the x-axis mirroring. Perfect. We need as well to say that the head or the neck should follow the spine, so as well here, keep offset. And the beard should follow the head, keep offset. So the head is now connected with the spine, but there's still a connection needed for the cola with the spine. So here as well, keep offset. And basically when everything is correct, so and I will test this now, then everything should move with me. And I just place it here. It looks very good. Everything looks good. Okay. So the preparation is done so far. Now it is time to just test this out, if the rig is working, and we do this here in object mode. This is just some magic happening, yeah, for sure, but and it is as well not in one-shot action. So we can always adjust our meta rig here and go back to this point and say generate rig and override our current rig so far. So this is working as well when you have already skin weights assigned to the rig. Then we are still able to override the rig, and this is working as well. So this is very cool to test stuff out. So for sure, we don't have a control rig so far. So I just select our meta rig and say generate rig. And it is, everything works basically fine. So when we disable the meta rig, we have now the control rig, and I say villager control rig, okay? And basically this looks good. I go to the viewport display and say in front, and there is much more just right than we saw before. So we have many, many little widgets here, which are useful for animating. So probably we should just disable the body or the axe so far, so we see completely the rig, what is Rigify creating here. And basically this looks good, because when we go now to pose mode, then we're able to move this, rotate this, and something like this. But this is just a rig. And basically it's not correct to parent the character to the control rig. And I will explain this in my next video, where I will talk about meta rig, control rig, and game rigs. But for presentation issues, I will just parent my character to the control rig as well possible, just to test out if everything is working. And for this, I will just select my go to object mode, select my character, then I will select the rig, and press Control P, and there we get this little menu here. And so far I will continue with automatic rates, and this is totally fine. And this is all. So when I select now the rig and go to pose mode, okay, and then I select this widget here, then we are able to move this, and we see the deformation of the character as well. For sure the skin weights are just not correct, and we have some other issues here as well, but basically you see that this is working, and we are able to move our legs, and as well here, for example, the head is as well possible to move this, and here as well with the beard, as I told you before, we have some issues with the skin weights, but this is not a problem so far. Basically, it is working everything perfectly. But this is just a character mesh, and I told you before that for the basic skin weights, I think it's good to just create first the human rig, then assign the mesh to the rig, and then later I will create the weapon slots and the further details for the rig, so that we don't get any influence of the character mesh to the rig, so that we can assign the correct vertices to the exact bone, and everything is better with this in this way. This is just my opinion, but yeah, this is depending on you how you can do this. As I mentioned before, this is just our villager control rig. I will just disable this and go back to the meta rig. And basically this is very easy now. I go just to the front view, and just collapse this here. Select the meta rig, go to edit mode. Don't select anything here. And just press Shift A to create a new bone, and this bone is now where our 3D cursor is, but it's not a problem. And I will just bring this somewhere here. So this will be the hand socket for for this side here. And as well here, I will rotate this, something like this. Basically, I think there it's correct. Okay, and when I check this out, it's not that good. When I go to front view, at the top view, then I will just bring this a little bit more into position. But it's not a problem. We are able to just key the position and rotation later as well. This is just for rigging issues to place this somewhere here. Okay, so this will be the slot where our weapon or object will be able to snap, and we are able to animate this slot later as well. This is just for creation the rig, okay? As I mentioned before, this is just a single bone. We need to name this. I will name this hand socket dot L, okay? And this one need as well a rigify type. So I go to pose mode, go here to the bone tab, and say super copy. And this is everything. So this is just a super copy. And I need to parent this bone to the hand so that this is following the hand as well. But I will first symmetrize this one here. So go back to edit mode and go here to amateur and symmetrize. So now it's here as well. And this one has as well the suffix R. So this is correct. And now I just check if X axis mirror is still enabled. Yes. And I select this one, then the hand controller, control P, keep offset. So now this hand socket is following my hand and the fingers as well following the hand, and everything is fine. So for sure we are able to place this super copy bone wherever we want to. Maybe we want to have a weapon here on the back, or maybe we want the weapon back here on the belt. Or on the trouser, or maybe here, this object as well here. So basically it is depending where you want to place this object, and basically you can place it everywhere. The only thing what you need to do, to know is that you need to parent this bone to something. So maybe you parent this to the head, or to the spine here. Yeah, it depends on which part of the body it should be, okay? To make everything correct, I just bring this 3D cursor back to zero. Then I add another bone. This bone will be the belt socket, okay? And I will place it somewhere here. When it doesn't matter. Maybe just something like this. It's not this big issue here. And the rotation maybe is not that a problem, because we are creating a widget with this bone here, and then we are able to reposition this, or maybe we are just adjusting the bone in the meta rig as well later, but it depends on you, okay? So again, here we need to enter the pose mode and give this the super copy the super copy rig type. So, and we need to parent this, and I think I will parent this as well to this bone keep offset. So this is following now the spine or the hips. Perfect. So the sockets are placed so far. The only thing what is really important now is the controller itself for the object. So we have our X here. It's still disabled, and we need to give it as well a bone so that we can control this object and place it to the sockets. Okay. So what we need to do now is again creating a new bone. And if you don't want that it is scaling in this direction, and it should stay on this part here, for sure we are able to just grab this part here and moving it down, or we just entering here the transform pivot point option And I go here to individual, and then it is well working like this, okay? So, okay, this is the X. And it depends on you if you want to have the origin here, or it should be here. It is up to you. It is not a big deal, so it's just how you want to animate something, okay? Okay, we have now this. Then I will just name this control object slugged. And I should care about what I'm writing. And for sure, we need to give this as well an super copy, a rig type, okay? Super copy rig type. So, and this is basically everything. We shouldn't parent this bone to anything because we want to animate this X or this object freely, and it shouldn't move anything. So when we moving the hand, then for sure this slot or this weapon in the hand should move with you. But if you want to just throw the X somewhere or just give it a nice animation to pull it into the air or something like this, then we need full control of this bone. And so this shouldn't be parented to anything. Basically, it should following the main controller. Yeah, this is true. But in this case, it shouldn't be following anything. I will show you how this works later, okay? So everything is done so far. Okay, then go to object mode. And we need to create again our rig. And when we have already a rig and want to override it, then you always need to enable the old rig so that we can override this. So now we selecting our meta rig and go now to the armature tab, scroll down, I don't need this one, scroll down and say advanced options, and there we have override or new. And basically everything is correct like this. So I want the rig name should be villager control rig, and the target rig should be this one. And basically this is all. So just enable our rig, say override, and now generate. So the meta rig can be disabled now. The rig is already new. We see that we have now here new widgets, and as well here. There's as well a new widget. So if I go now to pose mode, then we're still able to move our character. But we're not able to move our X so far because it's not parented to the rig so far. As well here, we have our widget here. And the good thing is we don't have any skin weights assigned to this widget, and this is why I separated the creation process of this. We still have here the hand and the widget is following it, but when we move the widget, then the hand socket, then there's no skin weight deformation for the mesh, and this was the reason why I did this, okay? So, okay, now I go here to object mode again. Select our X. Now I select our control rig and say control P, but not with automatic weights. I will just say with empty groups. Okay, basically it is assigned or parented now to the control rig. But if we go to pose mode, then it is still not following anything. And we need to define the correct vertices to the correct bone. So the only thing what we need to do now is, it's very easy to just select our X here. And we see already that we have here the control rig, and we have our X and our body are parented to this control rig so far. And we need to just enter the object data properties, and there we have all the vertex groups of the rig. And we need to find our correct vertex group. And basically this is our correct vertex group. I already found it, dev control object slot, because we want to have all the vertices to this one. So I enter edit mode, select everything, And then I just select dev control object slot and say assign. And this is all. So when I select now the rig, enter pose mode, select my controller. Now our axe is moving our controller and it is well rotating, moving, scaling as well, but I don't use scaling here. But now maybe you're wondering, how is it possible to snap it to the hand socket or to the other sockets here? And this is the only thing which is a little bit buffering me, because when you regenerate your rig, then you will lose this step, but basically it's not a big deal. So just select here in the pose mode, this controller, and go here to the bone constraint properties. And there I will just select one copy transform. I select here the target rig, and the bone should be the hand socket, for example, L. And it's immediately here. And this is what the copy constraint is doing. So we have the influence, and when we, for example, pull this to zero, then it's back here. And we are able to animate this freely. But if we give it full influence, and for sure we are able to key this influence value as well, then this axe will, where's our hand control? Then this axe will move my hand as well. And this is very good. And for example, here we have our hand socket itself, and we are able to just rotate this as well, give it a new position. Yeah, you see? And here is our object controller, and we are still able to manipulate the influence here. This is basically everything. So we just are able to give it another copy transform. Again, here, I select the target rig, then I say hand socket, and then say R, and now it's here. And very important is to select the correct controller. So hand socket R, okay? So now it's correct. And it is well important to keep the correct influence values. So this is overwriting now this one, but basically you are able to just say, okay, 0, 1, and we are able to just add another copy transform. So copy transform, yeah. Again, this one, and I will just say belt socket. So now it's here, okay? You see, this is very easy, and we are able to animate this now very easily as well. The only thing is, if you regenerate our rig, then we need to do the setup for this constraints again. And this can be annoying, but if you have any keyframes already here, it's not crashing those keyframes. If you building up the same constraint setup again, then everything is working as it was before and everything is fine. So this is now the Rigify rig with the character slots. So basically I prepared some more content for this video, so I want to introduce or talk about as well about bone groups and layers, and I planned to show this as well in this tutorial. But this video is a little bit long now, and I think there's nothing new or nothing special for doing the setup for this, and you find everything in the video from Toder, Rigify Bone Groups and Layers Advanced, or the two videos before this. So basically there's nothing special behind this. I would absolutely recommend this to work with bone groups and layers, because they make your animating process so much easier. So this means that I'm finished now with this tutorial, and I say thank you very much for watching, and if you like this video, please give me a like and subscribe to this YouTube channel, and as well subscribe to Toder and his videos as well, and probably to his Gumroad course as well. Till the next time, cheers.